world is cold, hell is hot. Prosper in the law, call it jackpot. Never saw your soul, this is food for thought.
Yeah, read what you got. Come on, friend, we your friend. We your friend. Read what you got.
Read what the book of Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 5.
Read.
Behold, I have taught you statutes and judgments.
Behold, I have taught you statutes and judgments. This is what the Lord said. Read on.
Even as the Lord my God commanded me.
Read on.
That you should do so in the land whither you go to possess.
Right, read.
Keep therefore and do them.
It says keep therefore and what?
And do them.
And do what?
And do them.
And keep the law, statutes, and commandments. Because a lot of people say they love God. Would you say you love God? You love God, right? Give me 1 John 5:3. Keep reading on that.
Keep therefore and do them.
Uh-huh.
For this is your wisdom.
This is our wisdom. Because a lot of people say they love God, but they're not doing what God told them to do.
They love God.
Right?
Don't love
if you
Jesus.
Do what God told you to do, this is your Jesus. Wisdom according to the Bible. Right? It's more than that.
Your wisdom and your understanding.
This is your wisdom and your understanding, right? So I'm gonna show you something real quick. Keep reading.
In the sight of the nations.
In the sight of the nations. Because a lot of people look at us like we just niggas and thugs, right? We keep our pants down low, right? We shooting our brother. We treating our women wrong. We not raising
That's
our children.
Why we got
right?
kicked off the land.
So they looking at us like we ain't nothing, right? Keep reading.
Which shall hear all these statutes, right? And say, surely this great nation,
right,
is a wise and understanding people.
So people look at us like right now, they say, they don't understand nothing because the way we live, we're not living right now. When you look at the so-called black man and black woman, we on the bottom of the earth. Would you agree with that? Would you say we riding the high places of the earth? Absolutely
nope.
not.
But it ain't our spot right now.
Right, absolutely.
It ain't our spot right now. That's why they had a whole world shut down. They just got confused.
Absolutely.
They just got confused. The whole world shut down.
Now ask an important question. I got you. Ask an important question. I asked, do you love God? Your answer is yes, right? And I'm sure you know how to love God already.
I love God.
Read what you got, brother.
This is the book of 1 John, chapter 5 and verse 3. For this is the love of God.
This is the love of God. This is how we love God, sisters and brother. Read on.
That we keep his commandments.
That we do what?
That we keep his commandments.
I ain't got to do that.
That we keep his commandments.
God going to love me no matter what.
That we keep his commandments.
The true love of God is to keep the commandments. If I tell my girl I love her, and I come home and I'm choking her out when I get home from work, I don't love my woman.
Right.
It's the same concept. You got to do what you've been told by the Heavenly Father. Give me 2 John 1:6.
It's the book of 2 John 1:6.
Read.
And this is love.
And this is what?
And this is love.
What did God say?
And this is love.
This is how we love God according to the Bible. Read on.
That we walk after his commandments.
No, we don't got to keep the commandments.
That we walk after his commandments.
I can do what the hell I want to do.
That we walk after his commandments.
I'm a grown man.
That we walk after his commandments.
This is the love of God, that we walk after his commandments. Read on.
This is the commandment that ye, as ye have heard from the beginning.
This is the commandment that you heard from the very beginning, sisters. Right? So when we talk about being a real woman or a real man, what would you consider a real man according to the scriptures? Right? Because a lot of times
a righteous of God's word.
The righteous of God's word.
He's afraid of God's commitments. He's afraid to go against God on 10 commandments.
So let's prove that out the Bible, right? Let's prove that out the Bible. Because a lot of women say, I'm looking for a real man.
But
let's see what a real man is according to the Bible. Read what you got.
It's the book of 1 Kings, chapter 2 and verse 2.
Read.
I go the way of all the earth. Be thou strong, therefore.
It say, be thou strong, therefore. Right? Read on.
And show thyself a man.
Show thyself who?
And show thyself a man.
Show thyself a man, not a woman, not a little boy, but a man. Read on.
And keep the charge of the Lord thy God.
Keep the charge of the Lord thy God. Read on.
To walk in his ways.
To walk in his ways. Read on.
To keep his statutes.
To keep his statutes. Read on.
And his commandments.
And his commandments. Read on.
And his judgments.
And his judgments. Read on.
And his testimonies.
And his testimonies. Read on.
As it is written in the law of Moses.
So you talk about a real man. You got to match a real man according to the scriptures, man. It's very simple. Yep. So now I gotta ask, now that we got on the men, what is a real woman of God?
Right
now, that's a good question. Because a lot of people say, I wanna be a woman of God, but do you really?
Right.
Do you really wanna be a woman of God? I'm gonna show you something real quick. Give me 1 Corinthians 11. Yeah, come. 1 Corinthians 11 and 3. Right? Let's see what that says. And give me Sirach chapter 26 and verse 25. Right? Read what you got.
This is the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 11, what?
11 and 3.
Okay. This is the book of 1 Corinthians, so, chapter sister, 11 and verse 3.
Hold on, brother. Give me a second. Let the scripture come out real quick, right? Read what you got.
But I would have you know
that
the head of every man is Christ.
So the first step to becoming a real man or a real woman of God is understanding order first. Right, so the first thing he said is what? Read on.
But I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ.
The head of every man is Christ. Read on.
And the head of the woman is the man.
And the head of the woman is the man. A lot of women like to say,
they don't
want to
hear that
no
more.
Daddy.
They say we fell
off. I
gotta
do what you say.
I mean, a lot of them
I do what I want to do, right? But that's not how God works. The Most High said, if you want a successful relationship, a righteous relationship, you got to understand the order. And I'm not talking about, when we talk about submission, I'm not talking about submitting yourself to any old nigga out in the street. I'm talking about submitting yourself to a man that truly believes in the words of the Most High.
Exactly.
Because if a man is not governed by something, he's going to lead you down to destruction. You can't have a man leading you down the path to destruction. You got to see what he's really talking about, what he's really about. You got to test his actions with the words of the Most High. Right? Keep reading.
Come. And the head of Christ is God.
And the head of Christ is God. So let's talk about the order real quick, because the church don't talk about this. Right? You have God, you have Christ, you have man, you have woman, and then you have child. Any organization that is successful, they have this same structure. You got the CEO, you got the COO, then you got the managers, the directors, the supervisors, and then all of the employees. And all of this comes down from the head, which is the CEO. So let's talk about the CEO. God is the CEO.
That's right.
So we got to understand what we're really doing here. This is the correct order that it should be following. But right now, everything is turned around, man. Right? The earth is not in its rightful place right now. This is why we have so many problems in relationships. Because we don't even understand that order. Right? A lot of our men just out here just dogging the women, doing what the hell they want to do. Right?
Trying to survive at the same time.
If you can't find a wife, let's see that. 26 and 25 real quick, and I'll go to your scripture.
It's the book of Sirach, chapter 26, verse 25.
So a lot of dudes say, why I got a headache, man? Why is this woman giving me a headache every day? I'm going to show you at the Bible why I say she giving you a headache.
Bring it
up, man.
A shameless woman shall be counted as a dog.
A shameless woman shall be counted. That's not the one I wanted. Give me a wicked woman is given as a portion. Come on, 26, 23. It's a lot. 26, 23.
This is the book of Sirach, chapter 26, verse 23.
Right, read.
A wicked woman.
I'll say that again.
A wicked woman,
read on.
Is given as a portion to a wicked man.
So if you're a wicked man, you're going to get a wicked woman in your life, man. Right? You're going to get that mirror that shine right in front of you. So you're going to have to understand why I'm on child support, man. Why she oppressing me like that? Give me Isaiah 3 and 12. And that's the one you had. Right?
This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 31, verse 10.
Uh-huh.
Who can find a virtuous woman?
Who can find a virtuous woman? Read on.
For her price is far above rubies.
Right, because she's very rare. When you find a good wife, she's going to build you, man. She's going to build your household. She's going to be there when your knees get weak, man. Right? A lot of men don't understand. You're looking at your woman for the wrong reason. Scripture say, give yourself not over to a light woman. What is a light woman? A woman that has the cares of this world. You want the Louis belt. Right? But you trying to build generational wealth, and she want a Louis belt. What a Louis belt gonna do for you? What a Louis belt gonna do for our children, man? Our legacy.
Right?
I'm thinking four generations down. Scripture said you gotta be a prudent man, meaning what? You gotta have care for the future. This is what a real man is according to the Bible, man. Right? So read what you got.
It's the book of Isaiah, chapter 3, and verse 12.
Let's see when we talk about child support and things of this nature, a wicked woman. How do we avoid these things? Remember, the scriptures say a wicked woman is given to a portion as a wicked man. But if you fall into the hands of that wicked woman, let's see what happens. Read on.
As for my people, children are their oppressors.
Children are what?
Children are their oppressors.
In today's world, this is what we call child support. You oppress men using child support. Read on.
And women rule over them.
Who rule over those children?
And women rule over them.
That's why a lot of our women single with babies right now. I gotta call it like it is. Because if we're not talking about it.
That's kind of like the reason why God put them with the children.
Right.
As far as, even if we wanted to have our children on our own, it always was already in prophecy that the women would be stuck with the babies.
No, but
because basically that's going to be with them.
Well, the point of the matter is having a father to guide this woman and a child.
Yeah.
But what happens is a lot of women, they rely on the government right now. They said the government tells you, if you get your man out your house, I'll give you rent for $16.
Exactly.
You can pay $16 in rent as long as a man don't live with you.
And that was,
who don't want that?
Wanted it because he gotta break it up.
Right, so not only do you get to pay $16 in rent, now you're collecting child support from the man. Now you're working 40 hours, and then you got a babysitter on the weekends. She got the baby 5 days a week, and then she dropped the baby off to you to watch him while she get to go out and have fun. This is a wicked system we talking about, man. They oppress the man. So when you talk about, when you take the man out of any equation of a nation, man, this is how you destroy a nation.
That's how you do.
You take the man out of the equation. So now our women are running. Our women need guidance, man. Right? Our women need strong in pure guidance. A lot of our women don't have that.
They don't even listen.
They strong-headed. They independent.
They listen to each other.
Right? Listening to each other. Right? Keeping single women keep single women
sharing,
single.
Man. Sharing.
Right? Yep. Freedom, man.
Oh my people, that which lead thee, cause thee to err.
The people that's leading these children are causing our children to err. Give me 2 Nephi 5:8. Because right now, when you talk about gangsters and thugs in the hood, a lot of these people, they're not raised by fathers, man. They're raised by women, and this is why you have to have that family structure in. Because what does a man bring? A man brings that dominance. A man brings that hammer in the house. Your mother can't whoop you like your father can.
That's right.
I don't care what nobody say.
That's right.
A whooping from your father is a completely different than a whooping from your mother.
That's right.
When you start getting your beard, what they say, the old folks, they say, you starting to smell yourself.
Yeah.
Right? You starting to smell yourself. You get 15, 16, you start seeing your muscles come in. Right? Your mom hit you, you woke your chest, and you're like, hit me again, I can take it. Right? But if your father do that,
chastise you.
You're not gonna do that. Read what you're
talking. It's the book of 2 Exodus, chapter 5:8.
I'll read.
There shall be confusion also in many places.
There's confusion in many places right now, man. Right? The earth is not working right, right? All right, let me give you a flyer, brother, before you go, man. Right. Our numbers on
what
there.
Y'all doing, man.
Yeah, absolutely. Our numbers on there. We have class every Saturday, brother. And the YouTube.
Take a flyer. Right?
Yeah. The YouTube's on there. Everything on there, brother. Right? You should come through. We have class tomorrow, brother. 12:30. Come through, man. Right? Absolutely.
I ain't making no excuses.
Right?
I just ain't gonna never agree. I can't be perfectly honest and say, yeah, I'm gonna beat up.
Right.
You feel me? But I have stuff to try to acknowledge myself to get the information I already got.
Right.
You feel me? So the only thing is my stuff is going fall through with it. So thank you.
There you go, brother.
But at the same time, go by the slide at the same time, bro.
Right, I got 2 more scriptures before you go, bro.
All right, before no lie, my name is Judah. All platforms, you can look up my music. You feel me? I'm into it. You feel me? I wanted them to say Judah so I can bring up this.
I got you.
Feel me? It's a way of sharing, like getting it out.
Right, before you go, let me give you the scripture.
Right, this is the book of James, chapter 1:22.
Uh-huh.
Be ye doers of the word.
So we got to be doers of the word. We got to follow through. Read on.
And not hearers only,
because it's easy to hear the word, but you got to put in that work, man.
Exactly.
Right, you got to get the work out.
Put into it, it will come at you.
Right, exactly. But so much is given, much is required.
But the Bible already said it, but people make it seem like it's
Right.
And not hearers only, deceiving your own self.
Right, read.
For if any be a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his natural face in a glass.
Right, he's like a man that behold his face in the glass, right? So meaning what? You have no purpose, man. Right? Yeah. You gotta put your hand to this plow and get to work out here, man.
There's a harvest. The man wants, you feel me? While we over here, you feel me, is trying to play plumber, because I can only tend to.
Right.
You feel me? But at the same time, females sometimes put themselves into the devil's position.
Right.
You feel me? Well, you need to reach out to many.
Right.
You feel me?
But that's why you gotta die. You gotta be that guy.
Yep. But they got
this is a hard thing, because nowadays, like I just said, our women think their men don't tell them what to do. Right? They don't accept correction. They don't accept anything.
They don't want to.
Right? But you gotta pray for that. The Most High gotta put that spirit on them.
You gotta pray for them. You gotta throw the seed. They can't catch, you gotta leave them. You gotta hope that they catch on.
Ecclesiastes 12:13.
It's the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 12:13.
Uh-huh.
Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter.
What is the conclusion of the whole matter? Read.
Fear God.
Do what?
Fear God.
Fear God, read on.
And keep his commandments.
So that's the ending of the whole matter. That's our purpose, to tell y'all to keep the commandments of God.
Like Christ.
You believe in Jesus first?
No problem.
That being said, brother, what we're trying to say is keep the commandments. Like, we got class tomorrow, come through.
The only thing I need to do is around more of my brother.
go to work. And so it's matching up. What I'm matching my Bible
with my history, with my own don't plug on.
One of the Bibles, not the Bible, but
Apocrypha.
Yeah,
it's the book of Sirach, chapter 37, verse 12. But be continually with a godly man.
Do that again.
Be continually with a godly man.
No, read it again.
Sirach, chapter 37 and 12. But be continually with a godly man.
Right, read.
Whom thou knowest to keep the commandments.
So that's a wisdom right there. You know that. You got to be around men that keep it. If you're around wicked people, you're
going to
fall into that wickedness.
You feel me? But sometimes, not really, because Jesus also walked in wood.
Well, scripture says,
I feel like I'm just, oh shit.
Right.
You feel me?
Right.
Then once I get through there with the wolves, I can pull my sheep and ox.
You feel me? Scripture says you got to watch the time that you keep the sinners. Man. It's not a sin to be around them,
yeah,
but you gotta be discreet. Exactly. You know, you gotta watch that time and then leave when it's time to leave, because you won't fall. Especially if you gotta
get out. Get in, get out.
It's the book of Psalms, chapter 1 and verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly.
So don't walk in the counsel of the ungodly. Don't walk in the counsel of the wicked people. Read on.
Nor standeth in the way of sinners.
Right, read.
Nor sitteth in the seat of the scorner.
Nor sitteth in the seat of the scorner. So to be a commandment keeping man, you gotta be around other men that are keeping.
Exactly.
Just that simple.
Exactly.
Right.
So sometimes I cry. Sometimes I just cry to motherfuckers like, oh, I got you.
Really?
Like, you run into people that you know that should have been with. Yeah. Like, how the hell did we get? How the hell we running this? How the hell we know this? But they're not. But then again, it's not this.
Right. So I'm gonna bring up the next speaker. With that being said, I wanna say shalom to the house of Israel.